In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. God our Father, may the hope and joy of your Holy Spirit ring in our hearts and resound in our song. We ask you to bless with your peace all who have prepared for us this performance. Bless our voices that we might confidently sing to your glory. And may this concert help ready us to receive that same joy and peace that filled the stable at our Savior's birth. We make this prayer to you in the name of Jesus, your Son. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Oh, My goodness, I wonder if this is true. Could it be possible that Buddy?
Yes, Mrs. C?
Buddy, I was just looking over my to-do list, and I definitely need to check with you on some items.
Absolutely. As your PEA, I'm always here to help, Mrs. C.
Pardon me, my PEA?
Yeah, PEA, Personal Office Assistant.
Oh dear, I thought you were just calling my secretary.
Oh, no. Mrs. C, the term changed last week from Elfish Secretary Help to Personal Elf Assistant. Unless, of course, you prefer to call me your CCC.
CCC?
Christmas Collaborative Colleague.
No, my PTA is fine. Let's just get back to my to-do list, shall we? I need to know if all the sugar cookie ornaments have been frosted for the tree in the main courtyard.
Yes, ma'am.
Have we polished all the reindeer bells and oiled the leather harnesses?
Finished yesterday.
Have the wreaths been hung on the workshop doors? How about the twinkle lights? Have they been strung in the grand elf ballroom?
Check and check.
And Santa's toothbrush, wool scarf, and extra pair of gloves have been packed in the sleigh.
Done.
Really? Well then, I can't believe it.
What's that, Mrs. C?
I'm done.
Done?
Done, Buddy. I'm done with my to-do list. It's a whole week before Christmas, and I've checked off every single item.
Well, Mrs. C, congratulations.
Can you believe it? Buddy, I don't think this has ever happened in the history of the North Pole.
I'm sure you're correct.
I've never reached the end of my list this early. I've never found myself with even a moment to spare until it's the stroke of midnight on Christmas Eve. I think I'll brew myself a cup of tea, put my feet up, and...
Answer your email?
I beg your pardon. What did you say?
Answer your email. Mrs. C, I'm sorry. But at this very moment, there are thousands and thousands of messages sitting in the North Pole inbox with your name on them.
My name? But I don't understand. Everyone writes to Santa. I never get any emails.
Well, Mrs. C, it looks like there are a lot of kids who've written to you this year because... Well, they feel they haven't gotten a straight answer from the big guy himself.
Really?
Oh, yes. And some of these emails, well, they're downright difficult questions.
Oh, dear. Well, I suppose this will have to be the last thing on my list, answering my email. It shouldn't take that long, right?
Right. But maybe you should talk to IT just in case. Buford, we need you in the video conference now. It's about Mrs. Claus's emails.
Yo, buddy. Mrs. Claus's emails, you say? Yep. I got them. Right here. Lots of them.
Oh, dear. How many?
Let's just say you've got more emails than the North Pole's got Christmas cookies.
Now, don't panic, Mrs. C. We're here for you. It looks like the North Pole IT department has helped us out and organized the letters into folders.
Folders?
Yep, they fill similar messages together.
Well, I suppose that will make things easier. I just thought a steaming cup of peppermint tea and a shortbread cookie sounded so lovely right about now.
Yo, Mrs. Claus, I don't mean to be rude, but I need some time to look super fly for the big elf office party tonight, if you know what I mean.
Oh, of course, Buford. Go right ahead and get that fly.
Yo, buddy, you're gonna be there tonight, right?
Of course, bro.
Cool, dude. Catch you later.
All right, my dear little P-O-O? P-C-C. Oh, never mind. Let's just tackle the first batch, buddy. Will you help me look through these emails?
Well, it looks like in this folder, they're all asking something along the lines. Dear Mrs. Claus, why didn't I get the blank I asked Santa for this year?
Fill in the blank. What's that?
You know, blank can be whatever.
Well, let me know the specifics. What exactly are these children asking for?
Let me see. A herd of Shetland ponies, a fighter plane, a roller coaster, a construction crane, a giant python, and in case of this little boy, a girlfriend.
Oh, dear.
So, Mrs. C, how would you like to reply?
Well, I'm not sure. Do you suppose the IT managers might be able to give us some advice?
Great idea. They're the ones who filled them, after all. They're online right now. Should I bring them on?
Please.
Belinda, Benny.
What can I help you with?
Yes.
Hello. I hope you received those sugar cookies I sent down to the mailroom earlier this week.
Oh, yes, Miss C. Thank you. They were delicious.
I think I ate a dozen.
Bunny! Well, that explains the crumbs in the box when I went back for a second one. Is there something you needed, Miss C?
Yes, Belinda, there is actually. How do you think I should respond to a child who didn't get something they asked for? Something rather impossible in their last email to Santa.
Well, those emails have always created a sticky situation for us.
Very sticky, like a wet candy cane in your coat pocket.
So when you go through the email, what do you do when a child's written for something that Santa can't possibly deliver?
Well, we've always had to, file those messages away.
Then we pretend they got erased.
Santa does his best, but he can't possibly please everyone all the time.
And as we elves like to say,
you get what you get.
And you don't throw fit.
I see. And I imagine there are quite a few emails like this from children every year.
Millions, Miss C. We file them away on a hard drive for a while and then...
we delete them. Dragged into the trash and erased forever.
Oh, dear.
What do you want to do, Miss C?
Well, I think the only thing we can do is send out a form letter that provides an answer while not really answering anything. Thank you, Belinda, Benny.
Hey, buddy. You're coming to the elf office bash later, aren't you?
Absolutely.
Meet you under the mistletoe.
Catch your sugar cookies later.
All right, buddy. Write this down.
Absolutely, Mrs. C. I'm ready.
Dear darling child, we are terribly sorry you did not receive your fill in the blank. Please understand that your request is quite difficult to fulfill. Your letter of concern has been considered and has now been passed on to the appropriate department. We hope you have a very Merry Christmas. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Good work, Mrs. C. Short, sweet, and a nice version of the truth.
Thank you. What's next?
All right, the next folder emails ask, Dear Mrs. Claus, how does Santa know where every kid lives?
Oh dear, I wonder if I can answer this.
Well, you might not be able to, but I know some elves in telecommunications and navigation department who can.
Oh yes, of course, Bill and Bob. I just sent them a tin of peppermint sandwich cookies. Let's bring them on.
Cool. Bill, Bob, jump on this conference call, would you?
Hi, Edio.
Yep. Copy that.
Bill, Bob, it's awfully nice to see you. I have a question for you two. Is it possible for Santa to know where every child in the world lives?
You bet. Telecom and Nav has always stayed on the cutting edge of modern technology with our newest, greatest system, the SGPS.
The SGPS?
That's right, the SANA Global Positioning System.
The big guy has a pretty sophisticated setup in his sleigh at this point.
Yep, he's got a global address list, topographic maps, satellite tracker with infrared images, and pretty much everything you need to find anyone anywhere.
In the past, he had to use a lot of gas station road maps.
And he pulled the sleigh over an awful lot to ask for directions.
Oh dear.
But now, with the SGPS, all of those problems are solved. All he needs now is an app.
Modern technology saves the day.
Well, you two have answered my question. Thank you.
We have the Telecommunication and Navigation Department. We're happy to be of service.
Hey, buddy, we'll see you at the Shigdig later, right? You're bringing the tunes?
Copy that.
All right, we'll set you up with the subwoofers for you, just like last year.
Yep, and we know you'll need the disco ball, so we're taking care of that, too.
That's a 10-4, fellas. Thank you.
All right, buddy. Write this down. Dear darling child, you have nothing to worry about in regard to Santa knowing where you live. He has a system that NASA themselves would envy, and if that were to fail, well, Santa has his ways. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Excellent, Mrs. Claus. Fine piece of work once again.
Thank you, buddy.
Do you need a break, Mrs. C?
Well, that's tempting, buddy, but I feel we're on a roll now. We should push through a few more.
All right, you're the boss. Let's see. The emails in the next folder are asking about Santa's health.
His health?
Oh, yes. And I have to say, some of these aren't too tactful.
Read an example.
Dear Mrs. Claus, is Santa too fat? Is he going to fit down my chimney?
Oh dear, you're right. They're not very subtle, are they? But I know just who to ask about this.
Me too. Should I bring him on?
Yes, but wait just a moment. All right, go ahead.
Bambo, Brandon, join this conference call, would you?
Hello, and how are Santa's personal trainers doing on this fine December day?
Perfect. I just finished a new Jingle Bell online aerobics class today.
I'm planning a nutrition webinar on red and green vegetables for all the elves next week.
That sounds wonderful. And Santa, how do you feel he's been doing lately?
Well, it's tough for him to squeeze in online exercises this time of year, but we're managing to keep up him on his schedule.
And what schedule would that be?
Well, he begins first thing in the morning with some yoga sun salutations, and then he's on his own for the quick jog around the workshops.
Then I fix him a cranberry power protein smoothie and deliver it to him.
After that, he lifts weights, full toy bags, 10 sets, 15 reps each.
He's not big on vegetables, but I can coax him into eating a salad with his lunch if I promise him a candy cane afterwards.
After lunch, he spends some time on the rock wall practicing his chimney climbing skills.
And then dinner is a healthy balance of protein, fiber, and carbs. By the way, Miss C, you remember what we talked about, don't you, in regard to Santa's cookie consumption?
Well, yes, but I have to confess, after dinner, he just loves a little something sweet.
And how many cookies would that be?
Oh, just 2 dozen.
What was that?
Just 2 dozen or so.
2 dozen?
Miss C.
Oh, dear. I know, but it's so unfair. He's inherited such a slow metabolism, and he's been under so much stress lately with the holidays. And everyone knows he's big boned, and the fact is, very few people can look slim in the color red.
Well, you know what this means, Bambo.
More cardio. I'll fit that into his schedule.
Thank you.
No problem, Missy. And thank you so much for those low-fat omu raisin cookies that you sent to the North Pole gym the other day.
You're welcome. Were they better than the tofu macaroons I made for you last year?
I have to say yes.
Well, I agree. The omu raisin cookies were delicious, but those macaroons offered so much more protein.
Oh, please, Brandon. If you're going to have a cookie, why not just have something really delicious? Let yourself get out of control once in a while.
Speaking of getting out of control, you're going to be at the Elf Festival later, right, buddy?
Who, me? Oh, yeah, I'll be there ready to burn some calories.
All right, buddy, ready to answer these emails?
I'm here for you, boss.
Here we go then. Dear darling child, Santa is certainly plump and there's no denying that, but never fear that he is unfit for the job. You can rest assured that Santa is in excellent condition for his age, and we here at the North Pole consider his health a top priority. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Done.
Excellent. I need a cookie.
So is that really true? The whole wearing the color red makes you look, well, oversized?
Definitely. And like Santa, I too seem to wear an awful lot of it.
Speaking of clothes, there's a folder email about Santa's outfit.
Really?
Yeah, here's one that sums it up. Dear Mrs. Claus, why does Santa dress up in a red suit? Has he always worn the same old thing?
Oh, this is a much easier set of questions.
For sure. Can I bring on wardrobe?
Please.
Briggs, Barry, hop on this call, please.
Bonjour.
Oui, bonjour. Madame Claus, I am loving that crimson top on you. You are the ballet of the ball today. Wouldn't you agree, Barrett?
Oui, she's magnificent.
Oh, this old thing? It's just something I pulled out of the back of my closet.
Oui, but it is wonderful. I love the whole look with the muff. Very chic.
Mr. C, wasn't there something you're going to ask Briggs and Barrett?
Yes, Madam Claus, are you in need of a wardrobe consultation? Something need hemming, perhaps?
Shall we find you a glittery accessory for the holidays?
Oh, no, no, nothing like that. I just need to know where the inspiration for Santa's suit came from.
Oh, well, that's a very, very long story, but we shall tell you the short and sweet version. Several centuries ago, an artist who is clearly a fashion genius extraordinaire decided to draw the figure of Santa in a red robe, stocking hats, and boots.
And voila, Santa has appeared in the handsome costume, designed for centuries. Details and accessories have changed over time, depending upon the fashion of the day, of course. But the basic ensemble has stayed the same. One day, you must visit us in the wardrobe department, Madame Claus, and pursue a lovely collection of historic Santa suits we have in storage.
Oui, Santa has worn everything from a fringed pashmina to a fur-lined pantaloons. One year, we considered dressing him in red bell-bottoms and a tie-dye coat, but alas, the outfit was not flattering.
Yes, that's understandable.
But the red will always be Santa's color. He's a winter, you know?
A winter?
Oui. Everyone has a seasonal palette of colors that are most flattering. For example, Madame Claus, you are a gorgeous spring. Wouldn't you agree, Babette?
Oui, Barrett. She was born to wear bright green. Not many are.
Do you really think so? Because I have this emerald-colored scarf that I never wear, and...
Mrs. C, are we done here? Do you have the information you need to write these letters?
Oh, yes, yes. Thank you so much. It's always such a pleasure to see you. Did you receive the French Madeleine cookies I sent over a few days ago?
Oh, we did. And we offer you a most heartfelt merci.
Oui, those cookies were exquisite. Soft and buttery in the delicate scallop shape. The perfect thing with a cup of chamomile tea. Madame Claus, you are a marvel.
Oh, well, you do flatter me so. Maybe we can have a lunch soon.
Oui.
But of course. And, Monsieur Bordy, I almost forgot to tell you. We have finished putting the final touches on your outfit for the tonight's occasion. It has the certain... Je ne sais quoi, you asked for.
Fantastic.
Toodaloo.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
I'm ready, Mrs. C.
Yes, back to business. Here's how I'll answer. Dear darling child, Santa's outfit has changed over time, but its design has always taken his comfort into consideration while encouraging him to make a strong fashion statement, a way we should all dress, I think. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Well said, Mrs. C. I like your style.
Merci. So, what's next, buddy?
Well, I hate to say it, but we need to move on to a more serious set of questions.
Serious, as in unhappy?
As in technical.
What's the theme?
Dear Mrs. Claus, how do Santa's reindeer really fly?
Oh, dear. That is serious.
I warned you. And you know who we're going to have to call in, don't you?
Oh, dear. Do we have to?
It's the only way we'll know.
But I just never understand what he's talking about.
Well, you're going to have to try in order to answer these letters. Shall I?
If we must, we must.
Oh, Barty! Video call!
Yes, may I help you?
Hey there, Barty boy. Since you're head of reindeer flight design, we have a question for you.
Oh, I'd prefer to be called by my full name, Bartholomew.
No problem, Big B. All right, Mrs. C, go ahead.
Miss Claus.
Yes, Bartholomew. I have to ask you about, I mean, I should know. Well, maybe you could tell me exactly how Santa's reindeer fly.
Oh, exactly?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Well, Miss Claus, I'm very pleased to explain it to you. Allow me to show you this diagram.
All right, Bartholomew, please go ahead only slowly.
Yes, of course. The first point to understand is that all of Sandy's reindeer possess the very rare Xmas chromosome, a gene that predisposes them for flight. We engineers in the reindeer flight design department assist them further in achieving liftoff by fitting up with a custom harness powered by a hydrogen fuel cell. This specialized piece of equipment is used in combination with reverse osmosis die thrusters, a set of air power propellers, and an emergency commuter valve, all which ensure speed and safety in the air. Now, in the event of a water landing, we've included a nitrogen-inflated PFD, which wraps around the girth, as you can see here. Now, given the factors of wind current and inclement weather, we've perfected a set of nostril blasters, which provide...
Oh, now, that was so informative, I understand perfectly.
But I haven't finished yet.
Oh, now, Bartholomew, I'm sure you weren't planning on wasting your precious time today answering a lot of questions about reindeer flight.
But, Miss Claus, you are, in fact, the first person outside of the reindeer flight design department to ask me anything about.
And at this point, I simply trust you're doing a magnificent job.
Oh, well, thank you. But are you sure you wouldn't like to see some other diagrams?
Oh, there's no need. You don't have to tell me anything else but whether the Linzer cookies I sent over to your department arrived in one piece.
Oh, they did. Thank you. I must say, I enjoy the nutty overtones of the cookie combined with the fruity sweetness of the cherry filling.
Oh, I'm so pleased you liked them. Would you like the recipe? I'm happy to send you a copy.
I don't know. Is it complicated?
Oh, I'm afraid it is, like getting reindeer to fly. So how about you focus on your complexities and I can just make them again for you next year.
Oh, that sounds quite acceptable. I believe you're doing an excellent job in the kitchen, Miss Claus.
Well then, we're each in our perfect department, aren't we?
Indubitably.
Thank you for your time, Bartholomew. Tell the reindeer to look for the peanut butter biscotti I sent over to the barn yesterday.
Oh, I will. But before I depart, I have an inquiry for Buddy.
What's up, Barty Bart?
I suspect you might be unveiling another deluxe fireworks package during tonight's celebration, am I right?
You are correct.
Well, then this year I'll make sure a fire extinguisher is ready and available.
Yeah. Good idea.
I'm not going to ask.
Miss Claus, Buddy.
Mrs. C, are you ready to answer this set of letters? Did you understand what Bartholomew explained?
Perfectly. Dear darling child, the answer to how Santa's reindeer flies is really quite simple. Christmas magic. Love, Mrs. Claus.
We're making pretty good progress, Mrs. C.
Oh, thank goodness. Do you suppose we could finally take a tea break?
Well, we could, but that would just put us behind.
We better keep going then.
That's the spirit. Next bunch of emails addresses another somewhat technical question.
Oh dear, what's that?
It says, Dear Mrs. Claus, how does Santa get his job done in one night?
Well, if they know anything about world geography, then they know that Santa can travel backward through the time zones, right?
Right.
So that he's always gaining an hour and eventually a whole day, correct?
Correct.
But I suppose we better consider getting some details from his pit crew, yes?
Yes.
Bring them on.
Buster, Barry, Barney!
Yeah, what's up? Oh, good afternoon, ma'am.
Howdy.
Good to see you, Mrs. C.
It's nice to see you, fellas. How are things going for Santa's pit crew?
Mighty good, Mrs. Claus. Looks like we'll have some fine weather for the big night.
Good, good. And the chocolate thumbprint cookies, you got those all right?
Yes, ma'am. They were good.
Hey, I didn't see hide nor hair of no thumbprint cookies. Buster, did you eat them all?
I don't know what you're talking about.
So, you guys are pretty busy on Christmas Eve, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Because as I understand it, Santa actually comes back to the North Pole many, many times, doesn't he?
He makes 365 round trips, ma'am. Gets a year's work done in a night, you might say.
And what exactly do all of you do when Santa pulls into the pit?
Well, ma'am, I de-ice the sleigh runners, scrape the windshield, and check in with Santa for any emergency repairs.
I look over the reindeer and reload the sleigh with toys from the production department.
And I refill Santa's thermos with hot chocolate.
I know you do a fine job, fellas.
Thank you, ma'am.
And about how long is a pit stop for Santa?
Our record time is 3.65 seconds, ma'am.
Oh, my. I'm sure NASCAR would love to talk to you three.
I'm sure they would, but we're loyal to the big guy.
Of course. Thank you. Aren't you guys going to ask Buddy something? All the other elves have been talking about an office party happening later. Are you three going to go?
No, ma'am. I don't think so. We don't hang out with those office elves too much.
You don't?
Nah, we don't really fit in with that crowd, if you know what I mean.
Not everyone appreciates the smell of grease and reindeer manure.
Come on now, fellas. You ought to come. I know some gals in the mailroom that love to meet you.
Are you talking about the one with the pretty smile and her two friends?
Oh, yeah.
Yowza. Yowza.
All right, fellas, we need to get back to work. Buddy will see you later at the party. Okay, Buddy, here's my reply. Dear darling child, it's with a lot of help that Santa is able to make all of his deliveries in one night. Behind every great man is a team of great people. Love, Mrs. Claus. Oh, Buddy, should I have another cookie?
Absolutely.
All right. I think I'm ready for the next folder.
All right. Let's see here. Every email in this folder seems to have been written by a particular type of child.
And what type would that be?
The sneaky one.
Oh, dear. Read on.
All right. Dear Mrs. Claus, how does Santa really know if I've been naughty or nice?
You know we can't tell them the truth.
Definitely not.
The whole system would break down.
Right.
They can never, ever, ever find out about.
Shh. Be careful, Mrs. C.
Yes, you're right. We need to be very careful. But I need to talk to you know who about you know what.
Really?
Yes.
You're sure?
Oh, yes.
You know they don't like being on video conference for the fear that someone will find their locations.
Buddy, I have a very, very important question for them. If you haven't noticed the name on the screen, it says Mrs. Claus. If I have to pull rank, I will.
Fine, fine. I'm only the PEA. I just do what I'm told. But we can't even be sure they'll answer. S.
Hello, are you there?
Who's to say we haven't been here the whole time?
Okay, well, Mrs. Claus has a question. Will you show yourselves?
Checking.
Checking for what?
Shh. All clear.
We apologize, Ms. Claus. It's just a routine sweep.
Sweep for what, may I ask?
Bugs, viruses, hackers, Zoom bombers.
Really?
Children are pretty technologically skillful these days, Mrs. Claus. They'll do anything to find out the secrets of the North Pole. And now they can snoop from the comfort of their own home.
Yeah, it's nothing like what happened with the crisis of 08.
What was that?
We found one in the sleigh.
A child managed to sneak aboard Santa's sleigh?
Affirmative, and the paperwork afterwards was a nightmare for a whole 9 months.
You can imagine how hard it would be now with online records, passwords, IP addresses. It would take the IT department years to recover if the North Pole database was hacked.
As Santa's secret spy service, we have a reputation to protect. We're excellent at what we do, but it must remain top secret. That...
Yes?
We're not perfect.
And what about the child? What happened to them?
That's confidential.
Let's just say he's off the list.
Which list?
All of them.
Oh, dear.
So, Mrs. Claus, I can't promise any answers, but did you have a question for us?
Yes. Yes, I do. I know that the SSSS elves are stationed all around the world, and you report back to Santa on what you observe as to who has been naughty and who has been nice. And considering that you know everything about what everyone is up to, I have a very important question.
Yes?
What's Santa getting me for Christmas?
That's confidential.
But I just can't stand the suspense any longer. I've looked in all of his usual hiding places, under the sleigh cushions, out in the reindeer barn, in his underwear drawer, and I just can't find anything. I know you know.
If we told you, Mrs. Claus?
We'd be forced to tidy up with pencil for the remainder of the holiday.
And Santa would demote us to security of the gift wrapping department.
You're sure you can't tell me? You can't even give me an eensy-weensy little bit of a hint? Well, fine.
Is there anything else, Mrs. Cole?
Oh, wait, did you find the ginger snap cookies I sent to your post office box?
Yes, thank you. They were delicious. But I'm afraid we have something to tell you.
They are a security risk.
Really?
Too noisy.
I bit into one of them and almost blew my cover in Paris.
Oh, dear. I'm very sorry about that. Next year, I can send you a quieter cookie. How about a batch of marshmallow fluff bars?
Too sticky. Our equipment would be a mess.
Powdered snowballs?
Too many fingerprints on our laptops.
Double coconut drop cookies.
Too much of a trail.
How about some chewy, unfrosted, bite-sized fig bars?
Perfect.
Speaking of perfect, buddy, should we set up the video equipment again tonight for your dance routine?
I didn't know you guys got last year's on film.
We get everything on film.
I want a copy of that.
Get online. It's still one of the top hits on YouTube.
Yes.
Thank you, Santa Spies. Good luck. Your secrets will stay safe with us.
So, Mrs. Claus, how do you want to respond?
Dear darling child, I'm afraid it's extremely top secret how Santa knows whether you've been naughty or nice. So, a word of advice. Be good, and you won't have to worry about it. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Perfect.
I thought so.
I have good news, Mrs. C.
I can have another cookie?
Yes, but that wasn't the good news. We have only one email left to answer.
Really? Just one? That's terrific.
Yep. And there really were no other emails like it. So in a way, it's in its own folder.
It must be pretty unique then.
Definitely. All the other children wrote to you about their concerns, things they wanted to know about their own benefit. But this one has Santa's best interest in mind.
How refreshing. Please read it to me.
Dear Mrs. Claus, I love Santa, and I want to bake him something he'll really like on Christmas Eve. What is his favorite cookie?
Well, finally, an email I can answer all on my own without any help from anyone.
Excellent. Lay it on me, Mrs. C.
Dear darling child, thank you for thinking of our dear Santa. His number one favorite cookie is a good old-fashioned gingerbread man with a glass of milk. Love, Mrs. Claus.
Done.
Done. Really?
Done.
Do you know what this means, buddy?
That is Quinn time. I can go ahead to the party and dunk Brognog in the eggnog again, just like last year.
Well, that wasn't quite what I was going to say, but yes, buddy, you are done for today. Thank you for all your help. Please go enjoy yourself.
No need to worry about that, Mrs. C. If there's one thing this PA is good at, is to have a good time.
Well, I can't believe it. I'm finally officially done. Here's the moment I can relax, put my feet up, brew myself that lovely cup of peppermint tea, and...
Ho, ho! My dear, dear Mrs. Claus, do you have some time to help me with some things on my to-do list?
Oh, dear.